per year from many hundreds of thousands to around 1,000. Tonight, thanks to your generosity,
oh, there is a lot of changes of clothes, and there's a lot of, like, at least three studios are coming in together. There is a lot of cultural overall. It's, I think it's like, what, 10 of us that he came together, and it's actually a lot of work, but it's worth it, because when you see such a result, and especially when you are able to cultivate culture, awareness of being friendly towards each other and extend a helping hand, because I think if we would be a better people towards each other, the world would be a much more friendly, happy place to live in.
Why we got good shit, don't embrace it. Why the feel for the need to replace me? You're on the wrong way, track from the good. I only painted a picture, telling where we could. But yeah, like a heart in a dash where it should. You done gave it away, you had it till you took it back. But I
scambariana betuleta. Oh my no.
I began my year as district governor 11 months ago, asking people to tear down the walls between clubs, between districts, between countries, come together for one purpose. And we've seen what has happened when that has happened together. 1.2 million Rotarians coming together to eradicate a disease for only the second time in the history of mankind, polio. Tonight, what we see are people that are tearing down every single wall, and it's not African or European. What we're seeing is an e-club that knows no bounds, that had a meeting that included people from Chicago, from Wisconsin, from Lithuania, and from Afghanistan.
My mother is a polio survivor, and I've witnessed it firsthand since I was a little kid, what it's like to be living with, coping with the consequences of the disease. And it's something that, as I was growing up, I thought it was completely eradicated. That's the impression I was under. And I just recently found out that in some parts of the world, there is still polio.
Our main theme is to inspire, And we're trying to do that with our dancing. And I think with this whole event in itself is trying to raise awareness on polio and et cetera. And I just feel like it's dope that we get to participate in that as well. So we're accomplishing our mission of inspiring and helping them out as well. So it's a lot of fun. As you can see, our group is pretty diverse. So it's just, I mean, we love the fact that we're just in, again, an environment that supports that. And
I'd like to say that what we have is a confederacy of clubs worldwide. Rotary begins at the club level. Each club is individual, but we come together for a common cause. So that's the strength of Rotary. It's something that was envisioned 107 years ago by Paul Harris. And I like to think that it's a vision that has stood the test of time.
As an artist, I try to help everybody I can, especially kids. To me, it's really important, and I do everything I can to help kids in any every possible way I can, whether through introducing them to music or to helping them through a cause like this to raise money to help children.
Tonight, it shows that we all can be together. Doesn't matter, Polish, Lithuanian, Ukrainian, Russian, or African-American. We can all come together for one night and make a great change, make a difference. And I think it's already a sign of friendship that will continue and hopefully for a long time.
It's fantastic. I'm really, really happy that the Eastern European community is so tight and close here. Everybody gets along really, really well. I wish they could take this example and bring it back to Eastern Europe and for everyone to be able to get along. Like, I have friends from Lithuania, Poland, Ukraine. They all come to my concerts, and they all, everybody's united through music, and I think it's, and through, other than music, through a lot of great causes like we have, like we see tonight. It's really incredible.
We'd like to say that we're this close to eradicating polio. We have that last, less than 1%.
What's next?
What's next is a question for many people to consider. But I did hear a speech by Bill Gates Sr. 3 years ago. His point is this, that maybe it's basic inoculations for children all over the world. Maybe it's not just polio, basic inoculations. But the other things that we have to address are things like water. There's a possibility that future world wars will be fought over water. Education, the list goes on.